In this VTScada tutorial, we'll be looking at the best way to set up VTScada for use with multiple monitors. Before we begin, let's start by taking a look at some of the Windows settings that I currently have configured. First off, we'll go into our display settings. Now here in display settings, it's important that we're set to extend these displays. Beyond that, we'll also want to check that both of our monitors, or in your case, perhaps all of your monitors, are set to a scaling of 100%. We'll also want to verify that the upper leftmost monitor in your setup is marked as the main display. Next, in the advanced display settings, we'll want to make sure that each of the monitors is set to the same resolution. In my case, that's 1920 by 1080, and we'll use that for the rest of the video. Now let's get started with a new VTScada application. To do so, we'll click the purple plus sign, and in this case, I'm just going to quick add a new application, and this will show us the default VTScada settings. So now we'll start our application. This information is available in the VTScada help files. Okay, now with VTScada running, we'll go up to the application configuration. And in the application configuration, we'll edit the properties. Now to start, I just want to show you some of the basic items that are default settings. It might be different than your application. First off, we're set as a resizable window, and we don't currently have any defined boundaries on our application window size. Now moving back to the advanced settings, we're going to look for a few specific display manager properties. In order to find these properties from the list, I'm going to put in DISP, MGR, and I'm starting off with vertical settings, so we do a V. The asterisks in VTScada note wildcards in your searches. So what we'll do is we'll click the Display Manager vert property, copy that property, and now you see that we can leave the property name the same, we'll leave the section the same, in the value, we'll give it a value of 1 because I have one vertical display. And though I can make this specific to a workstation if I have a redundant system, in our case we're just going to leave it as the default. Next I'm going to change the V to an H for the Display Manager horizontal. As before, we'll copy this setting. This time we're going to give this a value of 2 because I had 2 monitors connected currently. So we'll apply these settings and you'll see that VTScada will redraw the application such that we have our 2 windows. And there we see the application redrawn. Now if I zoom out to show you both of my monitors, what I'll do is I'll move one application window to one screen and I will maximize the other one. Now here you see that the application has not maximized to the full width of the monitor. In order to do this, we'll need to apply a couple more VTScada configuration settings to tell VTScada what size we want these windows to maximize to. Now if we go back up into the application configuration, this time we're still going to work with Display Manager. We'll enter Display Manager Height to pull up the application setting we need. Now here we'll copy the setting again, just as we did before, and this time we'll give this a value of 1080. Which is our monitor resolution. Now changing to the Display Manager Width, again we copy, and this time the value will be the width in pixels of my monitors, which is 1920. Okay, so now we apply these settings. Again, we're redrawn in VTScada. I'll zoom out to my 2 application windows, and this time when I maximize the windows, you'll see that they maximize to show a full VTScada application window in each display. Well, that concludes our VTScada tutorial. I'd encourage you to try adjusting some of these settings to see how you might be able to optimize your application. Did you find this video helpful? Please let us know in the comments below. And if you did like this video, please give us a thumbs up. If not, feel free to give us a thumbs down.